Hi everyone, my name is Ravi Prakash and welcome to the next class of LRDI. Okay, so here in the next few videos, we'll discuss about cubes, right? Very important topic. In every exam, question is asked from cubes. Okay, so we'll start with the right from basics, and we'll do some typical LRDI sets also, which are asked in cubes. Okay, so start with the basics, right? So we'll start with the basics. See, in you know what is cube, right? We done in mensuration also, no? So it is basically a cube is, right, make this kind of shape, right, a cuboidal shape with length, breadth and height, right? So in cube, length is equal to breadth is equal to height, right? So that is basically my market A. So we know what is volume of it, sorry, you know what is volume of cube, right? What is volume of cube? So volume of cube is what? It is A cube. What is the total surface area of cube? So total surface area of cube, right? How much it is? It is there are six faces, right? There are six faces. Since all are A now, since all are equal to A, so each face acts as a square. So in a cube, each face acts as a square, right? So each face acts as a square. So what is the total surface area? So total surface area is how many faces here? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. There are 6 faces, right, in a cube. See your room, right? In your room, there are 6 faces, 6 walls, okay? 4 walls plus top wall plus floor. Total 6. 6 faces, okay? So each face acts as a square. Area of a square is what? Side into side. So each face area is A square. So 6 face area is 6A square for cube, right? Then, we know the diagonal of cube, right? Diagonal of cube, we have discussed it. Diagonal of cube. Then we'll move to cutting and painting of cube, right? Very good concepts we'll do. Diagonal of cube. Okay, so diagonal, this is a diagonal of cube, right? So what is diagonal of cube? We have discussed it, right? D is equal to root under A square plus A square plus A square. It is Pythagoras theorem in 3D, three dimension, right? It is root 3A. This is the diagonal of cube, right? Number of corners in a cube. Number of corners, how many corners? 8 corners, right? See, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8. There are 8 corners in a cube, okay? Number of edges. How many edges in a cube? Edges, right? So, see how many edges here? We can mark edges here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. There are 12 edges here, right? So 12 edges. Number of edges is 12. Number of edges is 12. Number of corners is 8. Number of edges is 12, right? Number of faces we know is 6 now, okay? Number of faces is 6. Number of faces is how much? It is 6. Okay, I hope it is clear, right? So number of corners is 8. Number of edges is 12 and number of faces in a cube is 6. Okay, right. Now, then we come to cutting of cubes. Okay, then we come to cutting of cubes. Cutting of cubes. See, any cube, right? Any cube. Suppose I tell you that number of pieces, how many number of pieces, okay, we can cut. Okay, number of pieces obviously maximum, okay, when we make 3 cuts in a cube. Okay, so suppose we are allowed to make 3 cuts in a cube. Okay, we are allowed to make 3 cuts in a cube. So by 3 cut, right, in any direction, it's my wish, right? By 3 cuts, how many pieces I can take out? Okay, now see, assume here, see, best thing to assume is a cake, a cuboidal cake you assume, right? There's a cake. How many pieces you can cut out if you're given knife in your hand and you're told to make 3 cuts on the cake, right? So see here, what will happen? Again, I'm making 3-dimensional diagram to understand it better. Okay, so it's a 3-dimensional diagram of cube. So I have to make 3 cuts, right? So see, if I cut like this, horizontally, no? If I cut horizontally, okay? So, like this. Suppose this is a cake here. if I cut horizontally or vertically. Suppose I cut vertically. So 1, 2, 3. How many pieces? 1, 2, 3, 4. If you make 3 cuts, there will be 4 pieces. There will be 4 pieces. If you make 1 cut, there will be 2 pieces, right? There's a cake in front of you. You make 1 full cut. How many pieces? 2 pieces, right? 2 pieces will come aside. When you make 2 cuts, 1 cut, 2 cut. So 1 piece, 2 piece, 3 piece. Correct. Even when you make 3 cuts. So 1 cut, 1 piece. Second cut, second piece. Third cut, third piece, and this fourth one left out, right? So 3 cuts, fourth piece, 4 pieces, okay? So in one dimension, right, if you make all these 3 cuts, suppose you make all these 3 cuts like this, horizontally or vertically, that's in one dimension, okay? So if you make all these 3 cuts like this, if you make all these 3 cuts like this, 1, 2, 3. How many pieces? It will have 4 pieces, right? It will have 4 pieces there, 4 pieces, right? But what I want is maximum number of pieces, right? When we will get the maximum number of pieces. So see, this is the most common diagram of cube we should make always, right? This is 3-dimensional diagram, okay? But this is also 3-dimensional diagram, but it's a bit of better clarity, right? It will not get confusing also. 3-dimensional diagram, make a square like this. Join 2 lines here and here and here. Okay, it becomes a cube, right, with length. So exactly 3 faces are seen, right? So front, bottom, and side. So I know that opposite to this there is one face, opposite to this there is another face, and in bottom there is another face, right? So there are 6 faces in cube, okay? This can be easily seen here. So what I was saying here is that can be easily shown here, that if you are making 3 cuts, you are taking 4 pieces out of it, right? You are taking 4 pieces out of it. See how? So this, like, this is the first cut, okay? This is the first cut. So if I make in one direction, okay, this is the first cut, right? It's like this. First cut, then second cut. It's like this. I'm cutting like this, right? I'm cutting like this. Cutting like this horizontally. And this is the third cut. How many pieces? 1, 2, 3, and 4 pieces, right? But it's not the maximum. This is not the maximum, right? When it will be maximum? Okay. So when you see, okay, so 3 cuts. Okay, first point is 3 cuts in one dimension will give me 4 pieces. 4 pieces maximum, right? Now, second point, 3 cuts in 2 dimensions, right? That is 2 plus 1 will give me how many pieces? So 2 plus 1 means 2 cuts in one dimension and 1 cut in the other dimension. Okay, so let's see this point also here. 2 cuts, suppose I am cutting 2, I am making 2 cuts like this. 1 cut and 2 cuts. And suppose I am cutting 1 cut like this. Okay, I am making 1 cut like here. How many pieces? You can see how many pieces now. Okay, so this is one piece, right? This is one piece, no? This is one piece. This is one piece, right? Okay, and this is another piece. This side, another piece. This side, another piece, right? How many pieces here? So, how many pieces here? Let me make clear one. How many pieces here? Should be able to visualize properly. Okay, how many pieces here? So, see, when you are cutting like this, how many pieces? See, so these two cuts will give me 3 pieces, right? See, these two cuts, right? These two cuts has given me 3 pieces, right? You can see it easily here. Let me rub this also. You can see easily, right? No issue, I can make another one. Now you can see here, these two cuts I gave me 1, 2, 3 pieces, right? So 3 full pieces I got, right? Now again, this one cut in this direction, right? This one cut in this direction has given me another 2 pieces, right? So this one cut has given me 2 pieces, right? So how many pieces now, right? You can see here, right? 1, 2, 3 this side and 3 this side, 1, 2, 3. Total how many pieces? 6 pieces, right? 3 plus 3, 6 pieces. How do you get? 3 into 2, total 6 pieces. 3 into 2, total 6 pieces. So 3 cuts in 2 dimension, right? Visualize it. A cake in front of you, okay? You're cutting like this 2 times. So 3 pieces and you're making 1 more cut. So 3 pieces this side, 3 pieces this side. 3 plus 3, 6 pieces, right? So in 2 dimension, you can make 6 pieces, right? Now 3 cuts in 3 dimensions. 3 cuts in 3 dimensions. How many pieces? This is important, right? 3 cuts in 3 dimensions. That means 1 plus 1 plus 1 in each direction. Okay? So now 1 plus 1 plus 1 in each direction will give me how many cases now? let's make the diagram here. If I'm making a cube like this, cutting it one in each direction, right? So let's suppose vertically one. This is just one cut vertical. This is one cut horizontal. And this is another cut, right? From this side. This is the another cut. So you can see how many pieces you got here, right? How many pieces you got here? 1, 2. Similarly, 2 plus 2, 4. And similarly, this 4 and 4 backside. 4 plus 4, 8 cubed. How you got total? 8 pieces. This is the maximum, right? But how to do it? You do like this. 3 dimension, what? 1 plus 1 plus 1. So every one cut, you do like this, right? Every one cut will give me 2 pieces. Every one cut will give me 2 pieces. So 1 cut, 2 pieces. 1 cut, 2 pieces. 1 cut, 2 pieces, right? 2 into 2 into 2. Total 8 pieces. Every one cut will give me 2 pieces. So 2 into 2 into 2. 8 pieces. I'll get 8 pieces. This is the maximum. This is the maximum, right? So once you get this funda that distributing the cuts equally in the 3 dimensions, right, will give me maximum number of pieces. Okay, so let me write it here. Distributing the number of cuts equally or as close as possible, right? It is always not possible to make it equal. Right, this is inequality concept. We have done this in inequality also. Distributing the number of cuts equally or as close as possible. Distributing the number of cuts equally or as close as possible will give, sorry, in 3 dimensions should, right? In three dimensions should give the maximum number of pieces. Right? Very important point. Now see here, why so? Because we have done it to 1 plus 1 plus 1, so 2 into 2 into 2, total 8 pieces, right? So you can see this another question here. Suppose you have to make 6 cuts, right? 6 cuts in a cube. 6 cuts, what is the maximum number of pieces you can take out? If you are making 6 cuts, what is the maximum number of pieces you can take out? So what is the funda? 6 cuts, right? Distribute in 3 dimensions equally. So I can do it because it is multiple of 3, I can do it equally. 6 by 3 is 2, right? So 2 plus 2 plus 2, that means 2 vertically, 2 horizontally, and 2 in this direction, right? X, Y, and Z axis. So 2 plus 2 plus 2, I should distribute it, okay? So every 2 cuts will give me 3 pieces, right? Every 2 cuts will give me 3 pieces. So I should multiply it, 3 into 3 into 3, 27 pieces I will get. This is the answer, right? Maximum number of pieces is 27. I told you why you multiply. In cuts, we'll always add. In pieces, I'll always multiply. Why so? So one last time again, I'll make the diagram. After that, we should be able to do it mentally. Okay, one last time, we'll make the diagram again. To understand this, right? Now you can do it very easily and very fastly. After this, okay? Very easily and very fastly you can do it, right? Okay, see ya. 6 cuts, so maximum number of pieces is how much? 27, right? 6 cuts, what I told, 2 in each direction, no? So suppose 2 in this direction. So here 2 like this, 2 horizontally from between, okay? From between. Now 2 vertically. So 2 vertically, right? This is one cut and this is another cut vertically. And 2 along this axis, right? Here. So you can see how many pieces here. You can simply see it, right? You can see it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 pieces here. So how many such layers are there? 9 pieces in 9 pieces here. Similarly, 9 pieces in this layer. Similarly, 9 in this layer, right? 9 plus 9 plus 9, how? 27, right? That's why I told. Multiply 3 into 3 into 3, 27. 27, right? This is the funda and whole concept, right? Now we should be able to do it very fastly. Very fastly we should be able to do it now, right? Now see, if I give you a question, by 15 cuts, what is the maximum number of pieces you can take out? By making 15 cuts in a cube, what is the maximum number of pieces you can take out? Okay, so 15 cuts divide equally in all 3 directions. I can do it because it is a multiple of 5. 5 plus 5 plus 5, right? So 6 into 6 into 6, how much? 216, right? 216 is the answer. Maximum number of pieces is what? 216, right? Every variety will do, right? Don't worry, right? I know many of you are coming in mind, this question is coming in your mind that, okay, if it is not a multiple of 3, will do, no issue, right? Okay, now, 17 cuts. If there are 17 cuts, what is the maximum number of pieces you can take out? Maximum number of pieces if there are 17 cut. Again, same thing. Distribute in all three directions equally. So I can't do it equally now because it's not a multiple of 3, but I can keep the numbers as close as possible. So 17 by 3 is 5 point something. So I can keep the number as 6 plus 6 plus 5 in three dimensions. 6 cuts in one dimension, 6 cuts in other dimension, and 5 cuts in the other dimension, right? This is the closest, right? Don't do 5, 7, 7, right? See, or many do this mistake, right? 5, 7, 7. Okay, so if you do this mistake of 5, 7, 7, right? You can see here how many pieces you'll get here. Every 6 cut will give me 7 pieces. 6 cut will give me 7 pieces. And 5 cut will give me 6 pieces, right? It is 294. Now here, 5 cuts will give me 6 pieces. 7 cuts will give me 8 pieces. And 7 cuts will give me 8 pieces, right? 8 into 8, 64 into 6 into 8 into 8, right? So 8 into 8 is 64. And I did some mistake here, no? Okay, sorry, 5 plus 5 plus, and it should be 19 cuts, so 17 cuts only, no? So 5 plus 5 plus 7, not 5 plus 7 plus 7, 5 plus 5 plus 7, right? Okay, so 6 into 6, 36 into 8 is how much? 288, right? Which is maximum? This is maximum. Why maximum? Because this is closest, because difference is 1, 6, 6, 5, difference of only 1, right? This is the closest. Here, difference of 2, it is not the closest, right? So that's why always take the closest one, always take the closest one, right? Now, suppose I have to make 32 cuts. So 32 cuts in a cube, what is the maximum number of pieces I can cut out? So 32 cuts in a cube, what is the maximum number of pieces I can cut out? So you can do it easily. Okay, 32 cut divided equally in 3 parts. So 32 divided by 3 is 10 point something. So 10, 10, 12. Still gap of 2, 11, 11, 10, gap of only 1, so that is clear, right? 11, 11, 1, so 11 plus 11 plus 11, sorry, 11 plus 11 plus 12, sorry, 11 plus 11 plus 10, okay, 11 plus 11 plus 10, I should distribute like this, okay, so that means 11 cuts will give me 12 pieces, 11 cuts will give me 12 pieces, 10 cuts will give me 11 pieces, what is the answer? 12 into 12 into 11. 12 into 12 is 144. 144 into 10 is 1440. 1440 plus 144, 1584. So 1584 is the answer for this question. Correct. So I hope it is clear, right? This is for maximum number of pieces when number of cuts are given. Okay. Now, next one. Next one is for you. It's reverse, right? It's reverse. Its reverse is. Now, suppose I give you this example, right? 294 pieces are there. So you've got a 294 pieces from cube. What is the minimum number of cuts required? What is the minimum number of cuts required? If you're making 294 pieces out of a cube, right? What is the minimum number of cuts required for it, right? So it just reverse it. It just reverse, right? We just did this question, no? I told you that there are 17 cuts. So what is the maximum number of pieces? So you told 17 will be 6 plus 6 plus 5. So 6 cuts will be 7 pieces. 7 pieces and 5 cuts will be 6 pieces. 7, 7, 6, 294. So 294 pieces, right? So in 17 cuts, you can make 294 pieces, right? Similarly, so now for to making 294 pieces, what is the minimum number of cuts required, right? What, obviously, this is minimum number. I can't ask what is the number of cuts, right? Because then it is possible in many directions. You can say maximum number of cuts, how many? 293 cuts. Just one less than that, right? Then if you need 294 pieces, you can make 293 cuts. Okay. If you need 2 pieces, you can make 1 cut. You need 3 pieces, you can make 2 cuts. You need 4 pieces, you can make 3 cuts. You can make 294 pieces, you can make 293 cuts. Right. So, but minimum number of cuts required. Okay. So, for minimum number of cuts required, what again, we'll just go in reverse direction. Right. How to go in reverse direction? Again. So, what is the method for it? Method for it at factorize in 3. Factorize as again, 3 part, right? As in 3 dimensions, no? So, factorize for in 3 parts, like 7 into 7 into 6. So, it should be in 3 parts, right? Factorize as A into B into C, where A, B, C are as close as possible. A, B, C are as close as possible. Right? So factorize this in A, B, C as A, B, C are as close as possible. Right? So now 294, if you factorize it, the closest is obviously 7 into 7 into 6. This you can check by doing normal factorization. Or just what is 294, right? Just calculate it like, okay, it is 49 into 6, we know. What is 49, 7 into 7? 7, 7, 6, right? Now, these are pieces, right? For pieces multiply, for cut addition, 7 pieces will come by 6 cuts. 7 pieces will come by 6 cuts. 6 pieces will come by 5 cuts, right? I can't multiply the cuts, right? I have to add the cut. No, 1, 2, 3, 4 cuts, right? I have to add the cuts. So, 6 plus 6 plus, how many cuts? 17 cuts. That's the answer, right? 17 cuts was here. That's the answer. Okay. So, 294 pieces means how many cuts? 17 cuts, right? So, 294 pieces means 17 cuts. So, let's do another one. Another one we'll do. 512 pieces are taken from a cube, are cut out from a cube. What is the minimum number of cuts required? If 512 pieces are taken from a cube, what is the minimum number of cuts required? So, 512 pieces, right? So, you can see this. You have to factorize it in the form of A into B into C, which is as close as possible. So, I can see that what is 512? It is 8 cube. It is nothing but 8 cube. So, my work become very easy. So, 8 pieces in... So, what the meaning is? 8 pieces in this dimension, 8 pieces in this dimension, and 8 pieces in this dimension. Right? So, 8 pieces. So, how you'll get 8 pieces in this dimension? By making 7 cuts. Just one less than that. Right? So, 8 pieces. So, 7 cuts. 8 pieces. So, 7 cuts. 8 pieces, so 7 cuts. 7 plus 7 plus 7. Total 21 cuts. Okay. So for making 512 pieces, total 21 cuts are minimum. Minimum 21 cuts are required. Minimum 21 cuts are. Okay. I hope it is clear. So let's do some more problems. For making if 1001 pieces are cut out from a cube. 1001 pieces are cut out from a cube. What is the minimum number of cuts required? 1001 pieces are cut out from a cube. What is the minimum number of cuts required? Right. So this is a very famous number in quant. I hope we have done it many times in quant, right? So I hope you remember it. What is 1001? You should remember it as, it is factorization. It's what? 7 into 11 into 13. Factorization of 3 prime numbers, right? The factors of... So, its factors are 7, 11, 13. Okay. 3 consecutive prime numbers, right? That's it. We can't further break it. So, this is as close as possible. This is as close as possible. So, 7 pieces, 11 pieces, and 13 pieces. And 13 pieces, right? So, 7 pieces will give me how many cuts? 6 cuts, right? Every 6 cut will make 7 pieces. So, 6 cuts in one dimension. 11 pieces means 10 cuts in the other dimension. And 13 pieces means 12 cuts in the other dimension, right? 6 plus 10 plus 12, how many cuts? Total 28 cuts are required, right? 28 cuts are required to take 1001 pieces from the cube. Right? Okay. I hope it is clear, right? Okay. Do one more. Suppose for 504 pieces are cut out from a cube, right? By taking these numbers, what we are doing is taking the some common numbers, some famous numbers in quant also, right? So, we are just revising a bit of quant also here. 1001, 504, right? What is 504? If 504 pieces are cut out from a cube, what is the minimum number of cuts required? Okay, how much? So, what is 504? So, I hope you remember it is how much? It is 7 into 8 into 9. 504. 7 cuts means, 7 pieces means how many cuts? 7 pieces means 6 cuts. 8 pieces means 7 cuts. 9 pieces means 8 cuts. 6 plus 7 plus 8, total 21. So, 21 cuts in the minimum, at the minimum are required to make 504 pieces in a cube. Okay. So, this was all about the cutting of cubes, right? Cutting and factorization, all these basic concepts of cube, we have done with just some good problems here. Okay. So, in the next video, we'll do some good questions of painting and all. Okay. Cubes, painting and cutting, and then we'll do some fantastic sets on cube. Okay. So thank you. Do watch the next video.